Okay, folks, I know you're not done, but let's go ahead and at least look at maybe 11, 12, and 13. All right, and look at the answers for those. Okay, take a look. Now we're kind of doing all these changes together. Maybe we're not quite there. I think we don't get there until a few from now. But this is the section where it's really easy to make a mistake, isn't it? It's really easy to make a mistake. So if you ever get to a test situation, what I advise you to do is calculate your answers and then cover them up and do it again and see if you arrive at the same number. Because it is really easy to make a mistake here, folks. It's really easy to add something that you should be subtracting or vice versa. Okay? Now, remember we only analyze current assets and current liabilities. Did I give you any long-term assets or long-term liabilities to try to trick you? Okay? Well, I will in the rest of the homework. Okay? So don't let me trick you. Any questions on number 11, 12, or 13? You guys getting this? Okay? I know this is the hardest part of a cash flow statement. I want you to keep doing and learning the classification of cash flows. And what I want you to do before we meet again is to finish this worksheet. Do complete through, I think there's 20 in total, isn't there? Okay, so do 11 through 20. One last time, I'm putting the check figures up there so that you can know if you arrived at the right number. When we get together next time, I will show you exactly how we arrived at those numbers. Okay, and they kind of get progressively more difficult. All right, so hey, good job today. And any other questions before we sign off? All right, we'll see you guys next time. Thank you, bye.